I know that if you are anything like us, you like racing.
And winning.
Totally. And today we're going to show you how to make your own ball race course to see how you can make the ball win the race for being the slowest.
Let's do it. Gather your family, put on your thinking caps, and get these materials.
Toilet paper or paper towel rolls, the more the better. Scissors, tape, and something small that rolls, like marbles, bouncy balls, or even acorns, cherry tomatoes, or grapes. Thin materials that can coat the track, we chose sandpaper. First, you need to build the track. Cut the paper rolls in half and tape them together. Then tape them to the wall. You can make a track with multiple switchbacks where the ball changes directions, like this one, or you can make one really long track, like this one. If your ball, or tomato, doesn't make it to the bottom, then keep changing the track. Change the distance between the pieces, or do whatever you need to so that the ball can consistently make it to the bottom. When you have taped it up, drop your ball, or grape, or acorn, down the track and time it to see how long it takes.
4 seconds.
Now it is time to prepare your track for the race for slowness. The challenge is to cover the track with a material that will make your ball arrive at the bottom the slowest. You can cover it with anything thin. We chose coarse sandpaper. So we cut it in thin strips, taped them together, and stuck them on top of the track.
On your marks, get set, go.
Now it's your turn. You can cover the track with sandpaper like we did, or aluminum foil, bubble wrap, or any other thin material. And here's your Explore More challenge.
What happens if?
Let us know what material you covered your track with and whether it made the ball get to the bottom slower or faster. And to learn more about what causes those marbles to go faster or slower, keep listening. Here's our ball at the beginning of the race. Just like everything on Earth, the force of gravity pulls the ball towards the center of the Earth, or down. But the track is below it, pushing up, so it can't just drop straight to the ground. Because the track is slanted downwards, the marble begins to roll down the track. As the ball rolls, the ball and the track rub against each other, which slows down the ball. We call this force friction, and in Spanish, it is fricción. The friction pushes the opposite way that the ball is moving, and it slows the ball down. On this track, the ball is rolling on the paper roll, which is quite smooth. So when the ball and the paper rubbed against each other, they didn't create a lot of friction, and the ball didn't slow down very much. When we added the sandpaper to the track, the sandpaper is much rougher. You can feel this with your hand or by looking closer. The bumpier the surface, the more friction it creates when the ball and the track rub together, and the ball slows down. When we timed the ball on the sandpaper, it took longer for it to get to the bottom. It was the same track, the same ball. The only difference was that the sandpaper increased the friction of the track and slowed the ball down. Generally, the smoother the surface, the less friction is created and the faster the ball will roll over it. The bumpier the surface, the more friction it will create and the more slowly a ball will roll over it. We can also see friction at work all around us. If I slide a book across the table, I know that it is not going to keep going forever, and that is because of friction. When I push the book, I exert a force on the book. The book slides, rubbing the table, which creates friction, which slows down the book until it finally stops. If you keep your eyes open, you'll see examples of friction all around you. If you slide down the hallway in bare feet, not so fast. But if you slip on socks, you've reduced the friction and you slide faster. Or think about bicycling on gravel versus asphalt. It is so much faster on asphalt. That is where there is less friction. What other examples of friction do you see around you? Post your answer in the comment section below and try to use the word friction in your answer.
Until next time, my friends, explore